All right, so doing some integrals. This is out of 8-4, number 25. This is a trig substitution. And I see an a squared minus a u squared. So I want to do the appropriate substitution for that, which is u equals a sine theta. Now that's the way I'm talking from my notes. In reality, the u is just an x, and the a is just a 1. So when I said u equals a sine theta, that's all it is in this problem. cool. So then I need dx, and dx is cos theta, d theta. And I replace everything. So that denominator is interesting. It's a sine to the fourth. The dx is a cosine theta, d theta. And then this radical, and I could write it out and show you, but I've been writing them out and showing you. If you don't mind, I could do this one in my head. It's an easy one. When you plug sine in there, it's sine squared. 1 minus sine squared is cosine squared. It's in a radical. The square root of cosine squared is
cosine.
So the radical, I just cleaned up the radical in my head, and here it is. Writing all that down the last few days. I've been showing you all that, just writing all that down. But that time I knew what was happening. I knew it was kind of easy, and boom, there it is. So everything got replaced. It's not magic. It's this substitution, and then everything gets replaced. And now here I am. Now I don't like this. I don't think I like this. It's a cos squared and a sine to the fourth. Yeah. It's got these even powers, boy. You know, there's no odd powers. So that makes me think I can't play the odd man out game. If it's even powers, that makes me think I've got to do half angle formulas. I'm thinking about my trig strategies is what I'm doing. But I think because I have denominators that maybe there's some exceptions. Maybe I can... I'm just going to play. I mean, sometimes this is just playing and playing and playing. So I'm going to take the cos squared and make it 1 minus sine squared. That's not what I would usually do with even powers. But because I got this denominator, I'm doing that. Oh, my God.
That's how I felt last night.
Let's see. That's how I still feel.
I can play around and get there. Look, here's the thing about these trig identities. I can take one road and get to a certain spot. I can take a different road and end up in that same spot. I kind of like what she just said. I might abandon this. I could keep going with this and get someplace. Here's another thought. If I think of this as a cos squared over sine squared times another sine squared, I mean, this is a different way to think about this. And then a cos squared over a sine squared is a cotangent, a cotangent squared. So that's a cotangent squared. And then a 1 over sine squared, a 1 over sine squared is cosecant squared. So here I am with, now I have a problem that involves cotangents and cosecants. And I told you I wouldn't really do that to you. Although, what I would or could do to you is secants and tangents. And the truth is, the games you play with secants and tangents are quite analogous to the games you would play with cosecants and cotangents. So if we know how to do secants and tangents, we could do these. But I told you I wouldn't on a test or a quiz, and so I won't. That doesn't mean we can't do this homework. But
isn't that cosecant?
I'm going to let u equal cotangent, I think. I think that's how this works. Du is the derivative of cotangent. Anybody know that?
Negative.
You can look it up. It's negative cosecant squared. Now, are you happy?
Yes.
Just say yes. I don't really
yes.
care.
I
do. You are happy. I mean, this is working perfect. It's like a tangent squared with a secant squared on the end. I mean, when you let u equal tangent, du is secant squared. I mean, that's the game we were playing with tangents and secants. Anyway, here it is with cotangents and cosecants, and it kind of works the same way. If I let u equal cotangent, the derivative is cosecant squared. There's a negative sign there. But the negative sign will come out front, and that's a u squared. And what is that? Du. Now, now are you happy? Can you integrate a u squared?
Yeah.
Good job. One third u cubed. I mean, we're done. One third u cubed plus c. Wait a minute, I said we're done. We got to go back to what u was. What was u? Cotangent. Oh, wait a minute, we're still not done. I need to get these cotangent thetas back to x's. I get them back to x's by drawing a triangle and looking at this original trig relationship here. The original trig relationship said that the sine of theta was x over 1. That's how you think about that. And so that's an x over 1. That's opposite over hypotenuse based on this idea. Pythagorean theorem gives me this other side. And now maybe, if I remember, I can look at that triangle and tell you what is the cotangent of theta and fill that in here. By the way, whatever it is, it's going to be cubed. What is the cotangent of theta? Well, cotangent is the other way. Adjacent over opposite, I think.
Yeah.
Cotangent's adjacent over opposite. Tangent's opposite over adjacent. Cotangent is adjacent over opposite. So that's it. I'm done. I am finished. Adjacent over opposite cubed. So it was here where things kind of got weird, you know, and I started to go one route and abandoned it. I'm glad I did. This was better. This led me where I wanted to be. But anyway, that's the trick, isn't it? I mean, the trick is, like I kind of said, when you're doing 8-4 integrals, you get plenty of practice with this 8-3 stuff. I mean, this is, once you do the trig substitution, it turns into an 8-3 integral. How do you do these trig integrals? You have to get creative sometimes. But that was kind of a tough one, I think. Right in there. But, I mean, it turned out to be easy. When you make the right move, it wasn't tough. But there's a lot of wrong moves you could make that make it tough, I guess. Any other requests or concerns? Yeah, he did. He said 33. Let's look at that guy, I guess. Kind of looks funny. Get rid of this. 33 in 8-4. Get 1 over, and then it's written kind of funny. It's 4 plus 4x squared plus x to the 4th. 4 plus 4x squared plus x to the 4th dx. So, boy, oh boy. You know, again, I mean, that doesn't look like, see, that looks funny. See, first of all, but would you do integration by parts? Say no.
No.
And is it a trig integral? No. And, you know, you might think about factoring that denominator. You might think about this being an 8-5 type of integral, which is factoring the denominator and doing a partial fraction decomposition. But it doesn't look that factorable. Well, maybe it's, let me see, can I factor? Let me think about factoring a second. 2 plus x squared
Or x squared plus 2. It's written kind of backwards, which throws me off too. But anyway, I think it's an x squared plus 2 or a 2 plus x squared.
Squared.
Yeah, quantity squared. Yeah, that's what that is. That's the that. So that's kind of the trick. That was disguised, kind of. It was foiled out. I'd rather have it not foiled out. I'd rather have it factored like this. But if I'm thinking about 8, 5, then Jesus, it's a quadratic. It's a repeated quadratic. Oh boy, I don't have to go 8, 5 here. I could. It was in 8, 4, so maybe I should just think of this as x squared plus 2 quantity. You know, I know it's not in a square root, but it's still the quantity x squared plus 2 or 2 plus x squared. Anyway, I could do a trig substitution.
This looks like a really weird variation of arctangent.
Well, and but it's going to be, it's not arctangent. It's going to be a trig substitution, and which one is it?
Tan.
It is tan, because of the a squared plus u squared. All right, so what's my a?
Square root of 2.
Square root of 2. And what's my u?
X.
And usually these things are in a radical, but it still works if it's just the quantity squared like that. It doesn't have to be in a radical. So here we go. I'm going to let x equal the square root of 2 tan theta. I think that's the appropriate move here.
Yeah.
Trig substitution. But first you had to factor it, and now you got to do this. Okay, so let's do it. So then I need dx. Dx is the derivative of tan is secant squared. I start plugging all this stuff in. This is some work here. Let's see. In my numerator, I have the dx. If you don't mind, the dx is in the numerator. And so the dx is this, square root of 2 secant squared theta d theta. The denominator is a 2 plus that x squared. Now, what is that x? The square root of 2 tan theta. When I square that, what is that when I square it? 2 tan squared theta. And then that whole quantity is squared. So that's me making the appropriate trig substitution and doing it. So I filled it all in. That there I am. And then I know usually what we're doing is we're cleaning this up so we can get it out of the radical. Well, again, there's no radical here, but you still play the cleanup game the same way, which is factor out the 2. Of course, it's not out here, but factor the 2 out right here, and it's a 1 plus tangent squared. 1 plus tangent squared is secant squared. So this turns into 2 secant squared theta. Now, wait a minute. This turns into 2 secant squared theta. And then it is
squared.
That's my denominator. All right, hold on. I'm getting there. So the numerator is this. And we just cleaned up that denominator pretty well. We got that down there. And it is a 4 secant to the 4th theta, if you don't mind. What that is. Hey, I'm very happy, or I'm going to be happy. You know, first of all, I'm going to take that square root of 2 and that 4 and slide it on out front. And then I have a secant squared over a secant to the 4th. Guess what? You can cancel a couple secant squareds and you're left with a secant squared in your denominator, right?
Is that cosine squared?
But a secant squared in your denominator is just a cosine squared. So now I'm happy. I'm very happy. I like cosine squared, by the way. Or sine squared. I like these. I like these, and you should know how to do them. But first of all, before we move forward, just hold on a second. That was a heck of a job there. That was trig substitution, and then plug it in and you clean it up and you use that identity, but but it cleans all up to this, you know, so that, I feel like pausing and go get a snack, and now I got to come back and do this. And how do you do cos squared? Dude, there's only one way. It's the half angle formula, right? There's only one way to do cos squared. You don't play, there isn't, you don't have to play or think, you just, you're a robot, and you do the half angle formula. So what is it? It's, this guy's out front, and then it's 1/2, which I'm gonna write out front if you don't mind. It's 1/2, and then it's 1 + cos 2 theta. That, so that 1/2 and that quantity, is this cos squared turned into that. And that's called the half angle formula. And the reason I'm so happy is because once you know that, I mean, once you fill that in, now the rest is so easy to integrate. I mean, can you integrate A1?
Mm-hmm.
Theta. And can you integrate a cos 2 theta?
It's
sine 2 theta with a 1/2 out front from the little u substitution you had to do there. So the half angle formula is sweet. You use the half angle formula, and then it makes for a very easy integral. Now, what's out front? this square root of 2/8, if you don't mind. Plus c. Now, I'm pausing again. Go get another snack. Come back, because now I need to work on turning this back into x's. But sometimes I'm pausing, waiting to see how you guys are doing. So, any questions up until this point? You doing all right?
What did you get the first one half?
So, this.
Yeah.
Well, so this cos squared, it might have been more clear if I wrote it differently, but this cos squared is the half angle formula for cos squared.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, it's 1/2, 1 + cos 2 theta. And so when I filled it in there, I just went ahead and pulled the 1/2 out.
Yeah.
And then it was pretty easy to integrate. And now I guess I want to fill this in using my, I guess I need my triangle kind of. So we'll go back over here to the original statement here. What I like to do is solve for tan theta, so I divide by that. X over the square root of 2 is tan theta. Bless you. So now I'm going to draw my triangle, right triangle, with an angle called theta. And if this is true, the tangent of theta is X over square root of 2, then that's the opposite over the adjacent. So then Pythagorean's theorem lets me add those up, square them, add them up, square root it. So the hypotenuse is X squared plus 2. 2 plus x squared, like it says. Yeah, cool. But it is a square root on this hypotenuse. Yeah. So now I should be able to answer everything, except there is a little issue. And this, that what I have over here is the sine of 2 theta. And my picture is for the angle theta. And so this 2 theta is bad, and I need to get rid of it. And this kind of always happens, and it always happens in this moment. If you're ever integrating a cos squared, you end up with this cos 2 theta, you end up with this sine 2 theta, and you need to get back to thetas. So you use this identity right here, right now. The sine of 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. When you fill that in for the sine of 2 theta, the 1/2 kills the 2. So this answer is the square root of 2/8 theta plus sine theta cos theta. Is that what I'm getting? That sine of 2 theta has to be replaced with that double angle formula in order for me to read the triangle now and fill this in. I had to get back to regular theta, not 2 theta. So that's a move I do, we do, but it's a specific move. This identity is specifically used in these specific situations.
How happens to the 2?
Well, there was this half here. So the half times the 2 went away, right? All right, here we go, you guys. Here we go. I'm filling, I'm changing it back to x's. Can you tell me what theta is?
Arc tangent.
Good job. If tan theta is this, then theta is the arctangent of this. Yeah, you guys just said that. So theta is the arctangent of x over the square root of 2. Now I want the sine of theta. I'll look at my triangle, I guess. The sine of theta. Opposite over hypotenuse. Okay. That's the sine is opposite over hypotenuse. And then multiply by the cosine of theta, which is adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent over hypotenuse. This could clean up a little, but I've warned you or told you that you don't have to clean it up. So I'm just going to stop right there. That's a hell of an integral. That was this integral. I mean, that's this integral. Look at its answer. And how do you get there? Through this method, this trig substitution, right? It's crazy. I mean, these are difficult ones you guys are asking me about. You know, I was trying to talk about this test. I'd probably put this one into the hard category. Yeah.
Can we do number 14 on 8.2?
Maybe medium. Yes, 14 on 8.2, is that what you said? Mm-hmm. Okay. I haven't looked at that yet, but there is some funny ones in 8.2. Yeah, that's kind of a funny one. In 8.2, she just asked me about number 14, and it looks like this. It's an e to the 1 over t, and it has this t squared in the denominator. One of the things, I mean, it just looks kind of weird, but one of the things, if I know I'm in 8.2, then I'm thinking integration by parts. Even if I don't know I'm in 8.2, like on a test or a quiz, you might not know, but still, you might think integration by parts. But the truth is, I don't think I have to. And it'd be nasty. Anyway, it's already a confusing integration by parts if it was. So sometimes, and I guess I could do this to you on a test. I mean, what did I say this test was? 8.2 through 8.5? Maybe I better call it 8.1 through 8.5. What was 8.1?
Stuff you already knew.
Like U substitution and stuff like that. So, anyway, that's what they're doing here. This is not integration by parts. This is an old school U substitution problem. And will I do that to you on a test? Maybe. Maybe there's an old school U substitution problem somewhere in here. I don't know. I wouldn't count on a bunch of them, though. So that's what this is. So if you've tried integration by parts, I mean, it doesn't work, I don't think. I don't think there's a way, sometimes there's more than one method that works. But I think this is it. U substitution. You let U equal 1 over T. That's T to the negative 1. So the derivative is, if this is T to the negative 1, the derivative is negative T to the negative 2 dt, or negative 1 over t squared dt. Look, that 1 over t squared dt is right there. See that? Isn't that my du? So that's e to the u du. This problem just turned into e to the u du. Did I make one mistake?
Pulling the negative out front.
Thank you. There's a negative sign that I should take care of out front. You're right. But otherwise, that's what he is. He's an e to the u du. When you let that be u, du takes care of that for you, as illustrated here. Does anybody know how to integrate e to the u? Good job. I thought I was going to have to revoke all your transcripts. Negative e to the u plus c. What was u? 1 over t. All right.
That was fun.
That's fun stuff. More. What else you got?
Can we do 23 from 8.3?
23 and 8.3. Yikes. That sounds scary.
Maybe I'm kidding. Ooh. Oh no, I'm an 8.2. Hang on a second. 8.3, 23. Oh, a tangent to the fifth? Oh, I don't want to do a tangent to the fifth. I hate tangent to the fifth. I love math.
But I hate integrating tangent to the fifth.
It's just tough. We have to do it.
I was gonna ask that question too.
I mean, it's tough. It's tough. So you guys are asking tough ones. You know. I hope that means you're good at the good, easy ones. I mean, that's cool. If you're good at the easy ones, then that helps. And you're only struggling with the tough ones. You know, that's good. That's good to know.
Maybe can we try number 19
or 20? No, I'm kidding. That's easy. In fact, there's nothing to that.
See, this is secant of 4x. See, the funny thing is, there's no technique for this. You're supposed to have secant memorized, but I bet you nobody does. Okay. Actually, no.
No.
Damn it. I said nobody does, and I'm right.
No. Secant x plus tan x plus c.
Oh, okay. Somebody does know it. You're right. But secant's kind of weird. It's just a memorized formula from chapter 5, and it is the ln of absolute value of secant 4x plus tangent 4x. Now listen. So that's how you integrate a secant. But now, pretend I'm the student, and you're all the math teachers. What did I do wrong? Oh, I should have spit out a 1/4. Right. She's right. I mean, technically, there's... Yes. I mean, technically, I did a little u equals 4x, du is 4dx. I mean, that... Because the rule is secant u is the ln of secant u plus tangent u. Anyway, right, a 1/4 got spit out of this problem. Yeah, of course. Good. Anyway, so there wasn't nothing to that one except knowing that formula. So I like that one better than, that's 19. I like better than 23. There is.
Do we not? Can we do it, or is that for later?
Yeah, no, it was done in chapter 5. What was it? Chapter 5 was when you learned how to integrate, and you started by integrating x squared. But then you built up, and you learned to integrate all the trig functions, and you learned, and some of them were kind of weird, like integrating tangent is the negative natural log of cosine, and there's a little proof of that. It's easy. How do you integrate a tangent if you wanted to prove it? You make it sine over cosine, you let u equal cosine. I mean, so there's a way to do tangent, and there's a way to do secant, but I've chosen to sort of memorize this. Yeah, but he just asked me for the proof, so guess what? I'll do it. You ready? You do this. You multiply the numerator and the denominator by secant x plus tangent x. So what did I just multiply by? 1, which is legal in math. But where did I get this idea? Just from years of doing math. It's really kind of grabbing a rabbit out of your hat, right? It's kind of, but it works. When you do this, it works. Watch what happens. In your numerator, what do you get? You get secant squared plus secant tangent, right? In your denominator, what do you get? Because, by the way, it's just a 1. What do you get? You get secant x plus tangent x. You guys okay? And there's a dx out here, and I'm trying to integrate. So now guess what I do? Let u equal the denominator. If you let u equal the denominator, everything will fall into place. Watch du. What's the derivative of secant?
Secant
x, tangent x. What's the derivative of tangent? Secant squared. You just let u equal the denominator. You let u equal the denominator, and look what du is. Your numerator. So what did this just turn into? A 1 over u du. Anybody know how to integrate a 1 over u?
Ln
of u. And so it's the ln of this. So it's a cool little proof, but I would just memorize it. You guys okay? I don't know. He asked and took 3 minutes, so it's worth doing. I haven't done it before. That's rather strange. What else?
How about number 23?
I mean, these secants and tangents are kind of tough, but we have a strategy. Do you know what it is? I mean, I can verbalize it. That's what my job is, maybe. The strategies are, can you use identities? Can you get yourself a bunch of tangents with a secant squared on the end? Because then you let u equal tangent, and du kills your secant. Or, this is the strategy for secant tangent stuff. You go for that, a bunch of tangents with a secant squared on the end, or you try to get a bunch of secants, and then you want a secant tangent on the end. So that's my two cool little strategies. And for that one, it's weird. For 25, it's doable. What is 25 tangent cubed to? 2x? 15.
Secant cubed 2t dt.
Okay, all right, so I'm writing x instead of t. Okay, tangent cubed 2x, secant cubed 2x. And so I just stated a strategy, and so I think I'm going to try one of those strategies, and that is I'm going to move a secant and a tangent out on the end. Okay, remember, what was my two strategies? If I have a secant squared on the end, I want everybody else to be tangents. If I have a secant tan on the end, I want everybody else to be secants. So I think I'm going to try that. If I put a tangent and a secant out on the end, here they are, a tangent 2x and a secant 2x, here they are, they're out on the end. So I put them out on the end. So what's left over here? So I guess I got a tangent squared and a secant squared. And my game is I'm going to hold that and save that for my du. But that means I want the rest of this turned into secants. That's what I just said. So can I turn the rest of this into secants? A tangent squared can be turned into secants. It sure can. You got to do it right, you guys. Good. It's secant squared minus 1. And then this is secant squared. And then this crap's on the end. A lot of writing. But I totally accomplished my goal. I mean, I'm very happy now. I mean, sometimes I guess, you know, you guys, I don't know if you can see it. You know, I'm trying to get you to see things like I see things, but I got a lot more experience than you, but... But I'm saying, as soon as I wrote this, dude, I'm happy. I mean, I don't know if you're as happy as I am. You might look at that and see what the hell's the difference. I'm unhappy both ways. But Once I did this, I am so happy because I feel like I should let u equal secant of 2x, and then du is going to be the derivative, but it's going to wipe all that out, I think, because the derivative of secant is
secant
tangent. Yeah. It will spit out a 2.
It will be a 2 secant tangent.
2 secant 2x tangent 2x dx. So when I replace all this, what is this?
U squared minus 1.
Good job. U squared minus 1 in parentheses times this. What's this?
U squared.
And now what's all that underlying stuff? That's my du, or you could say it's your 1/2 du. Good. It's your 1/2 du. I'll pull the 1/2 out front, and then I'll call that du. Anyway, I mean, I did the right moves, and I got to the right place. I mean, now it finishes easily. You do have to distribute and then integrate. Make sure you distribute, then integrate. That's all there is to this now. Maybe I should pause. Should I pause? Any questions up until this point? I don't want to go too fast. You guys all right? Now you distribute and integrate. So it's a u to the fourth minus a u squared with a du. So let's integrate. 1/5 u to the fifth minus 1/3 u cubed. Put parentheses, put a 1/2 out front, put a plus c. You're totally done, except u is?
Secant
2x. And then you can fill that back in there. Right. You guys okay? That was cool. I like that one. Which one don't I like? That one. I like that one. I mean, it's just a tangent, so the same games apply, but it's a weirder game. This damn tangent to the fifth. What can I do with tangent to the fifth? I guess I can make them a tangent cubed. Make them a tangent cubed times a tangent squared. See, in a way, I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm just trying stuff. I guess I could do that. And then what can I do with tangent squared? Oh, I can make it a secant squared minus 1. Secant squared minus 1, I think. Yeah. So now I just made it that. You know, so I'm playing around. Anyway, I like to have a bunch of tangents with a secant squared on the end. I like that. But I kind of don't have that. What I got is a tangent cubed with I don't have a secant squared on the end. I kind of got a secant squared minus 1 on the end. I mean, it's all one quantity. But it's not exactly what I wanted. And a lot of students would get kind of misled and sort of do this wrong here. But if you distribute the tangent cubed, watch this. Make it tangent cubed times the secant squared. And then think of him as his own integral. Minus the tangent cubed is distributed times the secant squared. So there it is. Now that's its own integral. Now tangent cubed over here times this 1 is this tangent cubed guy. Let's see. That's just the way to do this problem. It's kind of tough. But now I can do this. I can do this. I'll let u equal tangent. What's du going to be? Secant squared. That's my strategy. So I get a u cubed, it's 1/4 u to the 4th. It spits out a 2, she said. Good. She said it spits out a 2 from your little 1/2 x, spits out a 2. She's right. So good. I can see all that coming. Okay, but now I got to work on this. This is a separate integral and it doesn't have the secant squared on it. So now I got to do him. So that's good. So this is done, or will be done. again, you guys are asking me some tough ones today. And I may just abandon this, but I'm about to show you how this ends, I guess. How do you do him now? He's a tangent cubed. Well, I guess I'll make him a right. A tangent times a tangent squared. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's kind of the strategy I used a few minutes ago, right? Mm-hmm. Anyway, maybe I'll do that again then. So then I'll take tangent squared and make him secant squared minus 1. So I'll have secant squared minus 1. But again, I'm kind of happy. I mean, if I let u equal tangent, du is secant squared. But I got this damn minus 1, you know? So this is not really working the way it sits. So what did I do? I'll distribute, okay? And then it'll be two different integrals. Right, so if I distribute, then it is a tangent times a secant squared. And I like that. I like to do tangent times secant squared. I will let u equal tangent, du will be secant squared. This will be beautiful. But then I also have the tangent times this 1, and that's a separate integral. I'm going to make it a plus sign, by the way, because that negative will distribute through here and make it plus a tangent times a 1 is just a tangent. How you guys doing? This is an easy one to get lost in, because I keep distributing and making myself new integrals, you know? But again, we let u equal tangent, du killed that. This was a u cubed, basically, with a 2 out front. Boom, I called it done. This is a u with a du out there, 2 out front. He's done. Done. What about him? He's memorized. I can tell he's all memorized very well.
Negative L and cosine.
Okay. All right. I love making fun of you guys. I'm glad you take it well. He's the negative L and of cosine x over 2. Technically, he would spit out a 2. Right. So it's finally done, but it what was it? It was one integral, and I kind of ended up splitting it into 3 integrals. Using this identity is weird. It's a tough one. Maybe we should quit. You want to quit?
Yeah.
All right. I'll see you later.
I didn't mean that kind of thing.